Anyway, back with Tyranny. Well, last time I did some quests in this prologue area, basically. And now I'm going back to the camps, I think, to complete those quests and move on. Yes. Oh yeah, I talked to one of these pairs people, which I think it was him. We need to do some more talking. Again, we are way more aggressive in this playthrough. That's one way to complete a quest. And we got a sword. Twisted iron sword. More DPS, less recovery, more armor penetration, less accuracy. Yeah, sure, we'll try it out. You are wielding a sword and a spear. The spear is weird, but it's really good, so for now I'll keep it. Get more accuracy, more recovery. I'm not sure. I am not sure. We'll see. Alright, that goes one quest. One of Nerat's dogs went wild. The disfavored have accused me of multiple murders. Okay. A spell of frenzy. They could move faster than our party and letting them escape without would undermine the mission. So I fueled them with rage to get them to stand and fight. Well, the mission is the mission. Kyros' load does not hold the magic, the mage culpable for that which cannot be controlled. That's interesting. Oh, we have some lore here. Bitter Quip is citing Magician's Folly. If in battle for Kyros' glory, a mage inadvertently harms someone protected by Kyros' peace, the mage is not legally at fault. Imagine the legal standing and treaties and laws they would have to pass in a world where there is government, but the world is also full of magicians. It would be insane. Like, we have issues right now with guns and knives, right? Imagine being able to use magic and do, I don't know, rocks from the sky or floods or whatever. How would you even try to regulate that? That would be really interesting, actually. You gained favor with Tunon because we know the not the lore, the law. Lore is a really nice stat. I should keep raising that. And why is that? So you eliminated folk can lord your knowledge over the rest of us. Dude, those are Kyros laws. I'm hearing some treason here. Interesting. So we have disregard the law, we have the letter of the law, and we have the spirit of the law, basically as answers. So the first answer that shields Bitter Quip is basically we are following the letter of the law that says the mages cannot be held responsible, period. The second answer is we don't care what the law says, it was wrong, you need to die. The third answer is the spirit of the law is protect mages that actually act in good faith and not do it on purpose. So, difficult choices. Like I said, we should probably go for the first answer because we are the representatives of Kyros who decide his laws being followed, stuff like that, right? We are Judge Dredd, basically. But the third answer is probably it goes into moral issues on can we interpret the will of Kyros or do we need to actually just do exactly what he says? Where does individuality goes inside the law in a world where one man's or woman's will is absolute? Again, really, really good writing. In this case, I think I would go with the letter of the law. I can see more extreme cases where I would go with the spirit, but for now I think we'll do that. And that Tunon also liked that somehow. Alright, cool. I like that. That was a really, really like tiny questline within a few dialogue trees, but really impactful. And again, this game has really good writing and I forgot my water. Let me be right back. The USB cable is trying to kill me. Jesus. Alright. After the assassination attempt, let's continue after I drink some water. Isotanis. Cepheus. I don't remember where the, you know, quests are. Okay. Isotanis and Cepheus is who we are looking for. Do I need to speak to these people? I spoke to them before, right? Yeah, okay. Can I get some training? I can, okay. I want dual wielding. We'll do that. You also get some dual wielding. You don't get anything, you don't get anything. What do you have? You have the exact same thing? Okay. I guess they both have this, the exact same thing. Did I speak to these people? I don't remember. It's been too long. Interesting. Is there an age? Like, can they conscript from a specific age and afterwards? Like 16 or something? I don't know. You gained favor with Blade and Mark. We haven't met or heard about Blade and Mark yet, I think. Alright, fine. 50 rings seems a small amount to pay. Think. Oh, the Beastmen are part of the Scarlet Chorus. New pack, okay. My god, this game has so much lore though. Kind of insane. And they were enslaved, interesting. Okay. Oh, there is Siren. She definitely wasn't here before.
Oh, look. Mother has returned. Have I gotten out of line? Have you come to punish me? Am I a bad girl? Or do you just want to use my power?
Talking to us or verse?
Do you remember me, Fatebinder? Now don't disappoint me.
I guess she's talking to us.
You used my flock as chaff for the Scarlet Chorus. You took my people. The followers of Siren. The Archon of Song.
Conquest decision. Okay.
Do I look like I can hurt her? These good people aren't here for my protection. Apparently,
I think she's a companion. I didn't use her in the first game, so I'm not sure.
Can't have me collecting followers again like I did in Lethian's Crossing, can we? If some people started worshipping me, is that...
She would be a really interesting companion.
Is Kyros really so insecure to worry about a little competition? Look at me! Do you think I seem dangerous? What harm can a 15-year-old girl cause? I'm only a child. So, Tunon's Fatebinder in the middle of a battlefield. Kyros must be desperate. You were sent to shame Ash and Narat into action, weren't you? Ash certainly needs someone to dig a heel into his back. If only to distract him from his problem. But Narat, he's just a cat. Playing with a realm-sized mouse, isn't he? I can't be expected to keep track of all his comings and goings, his plans and secret meetings, his betrayals. Anyway, we have a more important matter to deal with. There is something you can do to assist me.
What the? He's trying to charm us, I guess. Mesmerize.
Remove my helmet. Really? That's it? How disappointing. It was worth a try, I suppose. Though it appears to have been a colossal waste of effort.
Wow. That is a really aggressive thing to do to someone. And what? I guess the helmet kinda keeps her power in check, maybe?
I hoped you would assist me in a delicate matter. But it appears you're more nuisance than help. I have no further use for you. Perhaps later. You're dismissed, Fatebinder. I said dismissed until I have further need of you. Your presence displeases me.
For the love of Kyros! That was the Archon of Song in the flesh! You know the Archon? I dare say, traveling with you will prove most illuminating.
I wonder what happens if you remove it. That's interesting. Also, how much lore do I have? Lore. 40. I had exactly the same, the exact amount I needed. Alright, we need a lot more lore. Why am I minus on... Oh, the red geyser. That's not me actually, that's here. Okay, I have 44, that's better. 60 parry, damn. Not bad, not bad. Alright. Interesting meeting. Interesting meeting. Alright, do I have anything to sell? Not that I don't compare, I want to sell. Do I need this? Meh. I'm gonna need them for food, we'll keep them for now. I don't remember if the game has food, crafting, stuff like that. Little scrap. Cool. Not bad. Oh, it was broke completely. Huh. Okay. Good to know, I guess. I don't think he has anything I need. And if he does, I won't have the money for it, probably. Maybe we can take some of these. I don't think I have... Oh, yeah, okay. Let's get the things we don't have. Cool. Immunity to poisoned, that's not bad actually. Alright, magic. Oh, we have level ups. What am I doing with you? Accuracy, armor deflection. Maybe some strength. And what's next? Swaps position with an enemy and then stabs them. Increase weapon damage. Yeah, I would do that. You were going to be a healer, right? Okay. So, new magic. Good earth magic. Edge of Glory is what he has. 30% damage for 20 seconds, plus 2 resolve. Accuracy plus 15. Nice. We need more slots. But I can make his better, basically. Yes. Titan stats. Don't really care. Unravel minds. Damage plus dazed plus stun. That's not bad. Again. We don't have any slots. Yeah, I prefer that one. Spectral. Yes. How much? 57. Okay, those will do. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Okay, for now.
Can't teach an old dog new tricks.
Can't do that.
I guess that's it. Time to go to the disfavored camp. Yes. Cool. We have 6 days. We need to pick up the pace. Let me save just in case. So why is your different? You leveled up. So not sure why he has a different 5 there than here. Probably signifies something, but I'm not sure what. Alright, we need to do the quests before we go to the Archons. You have some crap, I don't care. Oh, that is Servius. Servius. Wow, okay. Not bad. The reward. Got a pin. Regenerating. 1% health every 6 seconds. That's not bad. Not great either. I'll give it to you. To our tank. We're missing one quest, right? That one. Isotanis. Alright, let's see. One-handed weapons and parry. I think I'm going parry, right? For my character. No, I'm going dodge. Let me see. Characters. I am going parry. I do want to put some pawns in magic. I don't want to spend all my pawns in swords, stuff like that for now. I think parry is fine. Yeah, both do the same thing, okay. I guess you can keep going on 100 weapons. Good.
Our time together has not gone to waste.
Do you level up? Can you level up by using training, really? How does that work? I'm not sure. Alright, you go. More of that. And let's see. Increase the defensive benefits from shields. Plus 40% shield effectiveness. Plus 40% is pretty good, actually. Plus 2 enemies engaged is also pretty good. We'll go there first. Tarkris Ari, may the Eddie claim your worthless life. I, Tarkris Ari of the Vendrin Guard, do take responsibility for the actions of my crew. Okay. Hate mail. Hate mail. We're still missing one person. No, there he is. ...1000 rings and favor with the disfavored. Cool. 1000 rings is... what? Like, I don't know, I don't remember how much... I think it's 10 gold or 10 bronze. So maybe every 100 copper is 1 bronze. Maybe. Alright, let's make a test. I have 472 out of 600 experience points. So if I do this 6, I will level up. Yes. Okay, I see. But I might not want to level up those skills. Okay. Yeah, 65 power is gonna be good enough for now. We're gonna focus on magic next or lore if we can find it. Alright, please. Yeah, we'll go for that. Change stance depending on the enemy. Cool. Okay. Am I saving with F5? No, it's F6. Okay. I didn't save at all for the first 40 minutes or so. Used to using F5, I'm not sure why it's F6.
How can we trust your rabble not to turn at this last moment? How many of your conscripts have family bonds to the Vendrian Guard? It is decided. The Disfavored will take the vanguard of the assault. It is the only way to assure success before the edict comes to pass.
I am the vanguard of your distraction. One of the best sentences in gaming.
Oh, you're so young. We can forgive you for being stupid. Without your Archon of Stone to bring down those walls, you're out of your element. Only the Chorus has the numbers required to swarm the walls from all sides. We will lead the vanguard of this battle.
The best the Chorus could accomplish would be leaving a ramp-shaped pile of corpses propped up against the walls for my warriors to use. Their fortifications are not a concern. Even understaffed, my Earthshakers could breach the masonry in short order.
Another brilliant idea! Cairn's cult is, we're sure, every bit as trustworthy and sane as the late Archon of Stone himself. You did notice the spire at the center of the citadel. Hard to miss it, being only the tallest thing on the horizon and such. Certainly your Earth mages won't do anything stupid like, say, breaking the spire's foundation. What could possibly go wrong?
You hear the voices in your head. We love saying the name Cairn just to watch him squirm. Graven Ass had so much hair back before he met us.
I trust them more than I trust your circus of rapists, cell swords, and turncoat tearsmen. Tunon's Fatebinder has arrived. Why is it my so-called allies are more willing to belittle than to assist? The Vendrian Guard have been the least of my headaches in this damned valley. Now that we are all assembled, I want reports. The Scarlet Chorus was going to resolve the Oathbreaker presence in the Outer Valley. What became of that?
Yes, what did become of that? We should know already, yet we do not. If we are not mistaken, the Fatebinder played a pivotal role in this operation. Fifth Eye. Shed light on this baffling question.
And look what showing them mercy has done for us. My scouts report seeing Chorus thugs fleeing your camp, defecting back to the enemy. They are abusing your mercy, and you either don't notice or don't care. The former is negligence. The latter is treachery. Iron Marshal, I understand we've established a foothold across the Mitanni. Report.
This is why I remember I didn't spare them. I'm gaining wrath with everybody. Nobody likes me. True to life.
A most wise judgment, good Fatebinder. The Oathbreaker captain will no doubt provide hours of entertainment. And perhaps even some useful information.
He has been a most delectable treat. So obstinate, so inarticulate in her flailing defiance. Okay. That guy is so disturbing.
This will be just like Stalwart, when your own conscripts chose suicide over service to the chorus. She'll be no different than the others. Petulant, uncooperative, and motivated to feed you false information. The Fatebinder is right. We argue over trivialities when we should be closing the vice on the Oathbreakers. Let us march on the double. The Disfavored will lead the charge.
You mean the Scarlet Chorus should lead the charge?
These guys are children, though.
Two-thirds of your region remains trapped outside the valley. Only the Chorus can bring to bear the strength and numbers this assault requires.
Enough! If these are my allies, why bother with the enemy? Even the lowborn Oathbreakers have the honor and decency to...
Oh, finish your thought, old chap. They have the honor and decency to... To what? To abide by some sort of deal you made with them?
Can you not hear the treachery in his words? How can we be sure he hasn't been stalling this whole campaign? His legion boasts of victory after victory, and yet these half-wits Oathbreakers suddenly give the Disfavored pause.
It's immaterial is what it is. The edict is all that matters now, and we will march on Ascension Hall and avenge our fallen brethren.
Yeah, let's see if we can make them work together. We can't.
With whom do you stand?
Now is not the time for compromise. One of us will have the honor of completing this glorious conquest. We know you will choose wisely. I don't think you can take the middle road here. I will try, but I'm pretty sure you will have to pick something.
You test my patience, Fatebinder.
I will just make enemies out of everybody.
Compromise that leaves all parties unsatisfied.
Cool.
Whom do you support? Are you going to let the Scarlet Chorus traitors have their way? Or will you stand by Kyros's true disciples, the Disfavored? You'd stand with the madman and his rabble? I am shocked. I counted you amongst our allies, and your name was held in some regard amongst my troops. So be it. I will add another name to our record of hate. Out of respect for the blue flag...
Wow. Aggressive.
I will proclaim where you stand. Leave my camp and don't look back.
A wise choice! The Scarlet Chorus will be honored to sign
the last
of the Ventrian Guard insult. Ravenash, we hereby order you to stand down and remain here at camp until we have secured the Citadel.
It's nice that you can take the middle road sometimes. It's nice that the game punishes you for doing that. In this specific world, right? This is the definition of might makes right. And then we get trampled.
If the Chorus leads the charge, they will fail. I will not sit idly by while the Edict claims my legion. The Disfavored will carve a path to the Citadel on our own, if that's what it takes.
Oh, great. No wonder they didn't take this place. But what the hell happened? Did we get teleported? Your guardian here came to your rescue.
I wasn't trying to save you. I was trying to save her.
And what happened, you bleeding hard iron shit tower?
I picked her up and she stabbed me. Put a dent in my side that I won't forget. So I put her down and dragged you out here to recuperate.
This is no time to narrate our life stories. If the edict comes crashing down on our heads, none of it will matter anyway.
On that note, better to leave now while we're well parted. You've made your allegiances clear. I hope you serve a good long term with the Scarlet Chorus, and that we never meet on the wrong side of the battlefield.
Okay, mate, go. That will be interesting. I didn't expect that, actually.
Very well. I'll remain at your side at least until this edict is resolved.
Yeah, wait until I get more people before you go. Magic to kill us all. He was my main character, I think, in my previous playthrough. It's gonna be interesting if he actually lives.
Don't take it too personally. That's as tall a compliment as he's ever expressed. As for you, you old sack of wine, this is war. Try to enjoy yourself.
So, the game won't explain what happened. Basically, they just hit each other. What was that? I don't know. Okay. Speak with fifth eye. Assault on the citadel. You have made your side known, blah blah blah. Speak with the fifth eye at the Scarlet Chorus camp. Okay, we need to leave. But before we do that, oh, that conversation should have happened hours ago.
What do you need? If you insist. I'm a Scarlet Fury. That should raise some flags for you. It means that I'm good at killing, and more importantly, that I enjoy it. What I won't enjoy are the pleasures of funerary rites packed with weeping mourners. Someday I'll fall in battle, and then they'll roll me into a mass grave or heap me atop a shit-stained wagon. One more anonymous, knife-riddled piece of meat. Until then, I plan to take whatever I can from life and have a little fun along the way.
Wow. Okay. Let's do half of this.
The Scarlet Chorus is mostly for madmen and peasants with rusty daggers. But it's also a little niche of freedom that I never had. Once I survived training and met my Scarlet Fury sisters, I saw a different side of the howling mob. For new recruits shoved to the front lines, training means surviving the first battle. Anything beyond that is for the fighters who show potential, whether as blade dancers or arcane madmen. There's nothing in the world like getting put through the paces as a Scarlet Fury. Every day is a test of your commitment and passion. Failure means death. The first few weeks were the hardest, but also the most rewarding. I earned my name, picked up some quality weapons, and met my sisters. The elite fighters of the Scarlet Chorus. Your typical Horde recruit fights with a rusty spoon and a chip on his shoulder, but the Scarlet Furies are, well, different. We focus our madness. We coordinate, we kill, we dance. It's like art. Imagine a sculpture that twisted in weird, beautiful angles, and then gutted you too fast for you to realize what was happening.
The voice of Nerad gave me this name. Won't ask her real name because Vers is her real name for her. Since the person she was doesn't matter.
What do you need to know?
Hesitated. Interesting.
What do you need to know?
That guy is crazy, legitimately crazy. I mean, it makes sense, right? If you consume people's souls or the memories, you would get lost in other people's psyches. Okay, I had enough. Jesus. Again, there's so many... dialogue options. And you get all of them at the start. Like, it should have given the dialogue options a bit at a time. So it would be better paced. Ooh, nice.
Will do.
New ability. And it's AoE too, I think. Alright. Let's get the seeds going. What happened to that lady whose name I don't remember? Yeah, sure. I will lead the vanguard. Do we need to rest? I don't think so. Meet the Scarlet Chorus at the Citadel. We have time to rest, but we're not tired, so I don't see why we would. Already did all the quests, so off we go.
Can't do that.
Let's get this done. And this is the first spire to the game too, I think.
Fifth Eye is just ahead, cavorting with some blood chanters to the east.
By custom, you're a judge, jury, and executioner. Today we must ask you to take on the last and more sublime of your sacred duties. Scale the wall, kill the mages. Okay.
Send them at me in waves.
Okay. Let's try this. A real thing. It's only one person. One per rest. Okay. Let's not try that then. I thought it was one per encounter.
Sorry about.
Why are you over there?
Not that.
Hello.